It's AumSum time! Hey guys, hold on! Now, let's guess the title of my next video. Now, check this guy. He ain't no normal cloud. He's big and thick. Mr. Rain Cloud. Hurry up! Write your guess in the comment section below. Can dogs detect cancer? Yeah! He's a super dog! Dogs' noses have more than 200 million sense receptors. Whoa! So, they have an extraordinary smelling ability. They also have an organ behind their nose called Jacobson's organ. It enhances their sniffing power. Now, cancer cells emit volatile organic compounds. They have a unique odor. By training their super sensitive noses, dogs can recognize cancerous odors. How? By sniffing the patient's breath or urine.
Topic: acid-base indicators. Why does a turmeric stain turn red? Oh no, you got a stain on the shirt. I know what you were thinking. Nope, there is no point. None of the two bottles are of any use. Listen to me. Don't wash the stain with the soapy solution. The stain will turn red. See? I told you. Do you know why this happened? This happened because the food which fell on the cloth had turmeric in it. The color of turmeric is yellow. It is a natural indicator which tells us whether a substance is an acid or base. Now, let us get back to those two bottles. One contained a lemon juice, while one contained a soapy solution. When we pour the lemon juice on the turmeric powder, we see that the color of turmeric powder is still yellow. This is because lemon juice is an acid. Turmeric does not change its color when it comes in contact with an acid, indicating that the lemon juice is an acid. However, when we pour the soapy solution on the turmeric powder, we see that the color of turmeric powder turns red. This is because soap is a base. When turmeric comes in contact with a base, it changes its color from yellow to red, indicating that the soapy solution is a base. That is why a turmeric stain turns red when it comes in contact with any kind of base. Topic: human tongue. Why does our tongue stick to a frozen pole?
Maybe our tongue has a magnet in it.
No! Our tongue is always covered with saliva, which is about 99% water. During cold weather, heat from our warm blood is regularly supplied to our tongue, preventing the saliva from freezing. Now, a metal pole is a very good conductor of heat. That is, it conducts heat very easily.
Aw, it's so kind-hearted.
Oh, just listen. During cold weather, the metal pole becomes frozen and does not have heat in it. Hence, when we keep our warm tongue on the frozen pole, it draws heat from our tongue faster than the blood can replenish it. Due to lack of heat, the saliva freezes and forms ice, causing the tongue to stick to the frozen pole. Why don't spiders stick to their webs?
I don't know.
Usually, a spider's web is made up of silk threads which are covered with droplets of glue. This glue makes the thread sticky. Now, when an insect flies through the web, the insect normally gets stuck to the sticky thread. But a spider does not get stuck because its legs have tiny hair-like structures called cilia. When a spider walks on a sticky thread, the cilia gets stuck onto the thread, helping the spider to get grip and support to walk. Now, as the point of contact is very less, the glue has very less surface area to stick. Hence, the spider easily pulls its legs without sticking. Besides this, a research suggests that certain spiders' legs are covered with a special chemical coating. This coating also helps the legs from sticking to the glue.
Why does salt make food taste better?
Wait, I'll explain. Salt, which is basically sodium chloride, makes almost everything taste better. Whether it is French fries, certain fruits, curries, or even cookies, we like at least a little salt in all these foods. According to researchers, we've evolved to like salt maybe because our bodies need salt for survival.
What? Salt for survival?
Indeed. Sodium present in salt maintains our blood pressure, transmits nerve impulses, etc. Whereas chloride is used to produce hydrochloric acid in our stomach. Hence, to obtain salt, we have gradually developed a taste for it. Thus, salt in food makes it appealing and tasty. In addition to this, it is found that salt suppresses bitterness better than sugar. Researchers aren't sure how. Some researchers suggest that salt neutralizes the bitter tongue receptors, while some suggest that on adding salt, the brain interprets the taste as less bitter.